for you see, dear ones, a Buddha is not bound to reincarnate, for a Buddha no longer sees itself as a personality, as a physical body. A Buddha has no desires, not because the desires have been cut off, but because the desires no longer remain when a being experiences itself as all that is. For dear ones, if you know yourself as the consciousness that is creating the forms, if you know yourself as the source of all forms, what possible happiness can you derive by focusing only upon limitation, by focusing only upon limited forms? For when you learn to see yourself and experience yourself beyond the limitations of physicality, you will find yourself connecting to a greater source of love, a greater source of truth, a greater source of happiness that exists as consciousness. This is the source of pure love. This is the source of all life. This is who you truly are. So a Buddha no longer views itself as a limited form. So what need is there to accomplish objectives in a material reality? If you have no desires for certain experiences, no desires to obtain certain objects, no desires to have certain relationships, then what is the need to continually reinvent life? What is the need to continually reincarnate here? For your desires have been fulfilled. For you know yourself as all of life, no longer wishing or wanting any particular experience, for you know that the experience already exists within you. You know this as your experience. It is not a thought. It is not a squashing of your desires. It is not a pushing away of that which is within your heart. It is a surrendering of who you think you are as a limited being, surrendering all ideas into the totality of consciousness, into what you truly are. And this, dear ones, happens in this moment. It is a surrendering of identification, a surrendering of any thoughts of identification, surrendering completely and totally into this moment, so that you may return once again to full awareness of all that you are. Surrender. No desires to add to the limitation. No desires to change yourself into another form. For that is only desires of ego, and that is not the teachings of a Buddhic one, of a Buddha, an awakened one. For you see, dear ones, throughout the history of the planet, the teachers that we hold dear, the Buddha, Jesus Christ, Mohammed, these awakened beings, their experiences and their wisdom have been lost, have been changed as they were interpreted by the egoic minds of men and women. The teachings of the Buddha are lost, dear ones, but the essence of the Buddha remains. For what the Buddha realized is what you all are, and what you all may realize as you surrender into this moment, into yourself. It is not a recreating of who you are. It is a remembering, a recognition. No work is necessary to create a new you. Instead, the new you that you want to be must be given up, and the old you that you think yourself to be must be surrendered. It is only then when you will experience the freedom of who you truly are as consciousness, no longer identified with form, no longer needing to reincarnate to have experiences, instead simply existing in wholeness, in completeness, within the world of form. Yes, the Buddha had a body after his realization, after his awakening, but he saw it only as form appearing within consciousness, only form in which he was existing. For he did not limit himself by identifying himself with the form, yet he realized that the form remains and his consciousness is existing within the form. And he surrendered into the experience. He surrendered and found the love of life, the fullness of his being as who he is. And he continued to teach. He continued to share himself, existing within this form, yet also existing as all of consciousness. It is an experience that the mind cannot understand. The mind cannot conceptualize being in two places at one time, existing as two things at one moment. For you see, dear ones, the mind is based upon linearity, a linear sense of time, cause and effect, separation of one and another. When you add more than one in, when you embrace the infinite nature of your true being, the mind is confused, for the mind is not built to embrace and experience these levels of existence. So the mind must be surrendered. The thoughts of yourself must be given up and surrendered as you choose to experience who you are beyond your thinking mind. Do not push away your mind. Do not seek to purify your mind through time-bound linear processes. For if you think the purification of the mind happens based on time, then you are still viewing the mind from within the mind, for time only exists within the mind. True, complete, and total purification of the mind can only be achieved when you rise above the mind. For the solution to the problems of your mind exists when your consciousness is recognized as being beyond, separate, and greater than your physical mind. Know this. Look at the spiritual teachings in your world, the ones that create desires based upon identification with separation in your life. Are you seeking material things? Are you seeking material experiences? If that is true, and if you are following spiritual teachings that tell you to change your physicality, to manipulate the world, to seek material things that you crave, then know that you are lost within the cycle of samsara, lost within the cycle of reincarnation, for your desires to manifest here are keeping your awareness bound to only this material world. Yet you are so much greater. You are so much greater than only this experience. You are so much greater than only this material world. You must surrender your desires of this material world in order to see beyond the scope of what exists within consciousness. This is freedom, dear ones. It is a surrendering of your idea of limitation, so that you may expand yourself to experience all that is.